columns from two or more tables by using values common to both tables. So if you want to combine the two tables, so one or more columns should be same. Minimum one column should be same in both the tables. Then only we can combine the two tables. So to combine the two tables, we will use the keyword known as join. We'll give the command known as join command. So this join keyword is used in SQL queries for joining the table. So if you want to join in the table, if you want to join the table, the one or more columns should be same in both the tables. So minimum one column should be same in both the tables. So the minimum requirement condition is n minus 1. A table can also join to itself, known as self-join. That means joining the table to itself is nothing but a self-join. So we are having different types of joins in SQL. So one is the Cartesian product, and the other one is the inner join. Next is the outer join. This outer join is divided into two: left outer join and right outer join. And next is the equi join, and last one is the self join. That means joining the table to itself. So first of all, we will see about this Cartesian product. So this Cartesian product returns all rows from the first table. Each row from the first table is combined with all the rows of the second table. So it will retrieve the records which satisfies the condition. That means the first row of the first table will be combined with all the rows in the second table. That means if the particular column matches, then it will if a particular column matches, then it will retrieve the records. The particular column matches, then it will retrieve the records. So that is called as an Cartesian product. Next is the inner join. This inner join is a Cartesian product that satisfies the join condition in the where clause. So here where clause is nothing but satisfy the condition. Where will give the condition. So if this particular condition or if this particular criteria satisfies only, then it will retrieve the records in from the both tables. So that is the inner join. Next is the equi join. So equi join is nothing but, so here in where clause is based on the equality condition. So that means in where condition we will give equal to symbol, equality condition. That means where job is equal to manager, or where salary is equal to 3000. So for that particular condition, then it will retrieve the rows. That means based on the criteria that we have given. So in that criteria, if you give equality symbol, then it is called as an equi join. So in this join, where clause is based on the equality condition. Hence it is called as an equi join. Next we are having the outer join. It retrieves all rows that match the where clause and also those that have a null value in the column used for join. That means it will retrieve all the rows that matches the condition, and also it will retrieve the rows that are having the null values. Not only the condition but also the null values. That is called as an outer join. So this outer join is divided into two. One is the left outer joins and another one is the right outer joins. So a left outer join includes all records from the first of the two tables, from the left of the two tables. The outer right outer join includes all the records from the right of the two tables. So that is the difference between the left outer join and another one is the right outer join. So now we will see about this views in SQL. Views. A view is a kind of virtual table. Views are tables whose contents are taken or derived from other tables. That means we will derive or we will copy the contents of one table and we will create a view. It is not a table, it is a view. The main difference between a view and table is nothing but A view appears like a table with columns and rows, but in reality, the view does not exist in database as a stored set of values. That means it won't occupy any space in a memory. It won't occupy any space in memory. Just it will appear. Just it will, we can see the rows and columns. That's all. It won't occupy the space in memory. A view is like a window through which we can see a limited region of an actual table. The table from where the actual data is obtained is nothing but source table. So here, now we will see how to create a view. If you want to create a view, we will give the command known as create view, and next we must give the view name, and next column name 1, column name 2, so on, as query. We'll give the query here. For example, my view name is view customer details. I'm having one table known as customer details. For this particular customer details, I will create a view known as view customer details. So here we'll give the view command as create view customer details as select asterisk from customer details. That means we are creating a view known as view customer details, and we are copying all the rows and columns from the customer details into the view, like that. So like that we can create a view. So all the records in customer details will be copied to view customer details, but we can see the records in view customer details, but in reality it won't occupy any space in the memory. So if you want to see all the records in the view customer details, directly you can give select asterisk from view customer details. Directly we can see all the records in the view customer details. Suppose I'm created one view known as employees. If I want to see all the records, then I will give select asterisk from view employees. So if I want to see the records whose condition is age greater than 23, I want to see the records whose age is greater than 23, then here in where clause we are giving the condition as age greater than 23. So we will write this particular query as select asterisk from view employees where clause we are using here, where age greater than 23. Okay, like that we can create the view, and also we can see the data in that particular, we can see the rows and columns in particular view. Next we are having the types of views: horizontal view, vertical view. So what is a horizontal view? Horizontal view restricts a user's access to only selected rows of a table. Okay, we can see only the restricts the user's access to only selected rows of a table. Whereas in case of vertical views, a view which selects only few columns in a table. We can see only the few columns in a table. Vertical view restricts the user access to only certain columns of a table. We cannot see the whole table, whole columns. Row column subset views. So that means create view. Here we are having the view name as view cust. So view cust vertical hor, as that means vertical horizontal, as select cust ID, account number, account type from customer details. That means I'm having one table known as customer details. Okay, I'm having one table known as customer details. From that customer details, I'm creating a view of name as view cust horizontal. That means what are the columns I want to see here? Cust ID, account number, account type. These are the three columns I want to create from the customer details. I want to create a view. So here I am giving the condition where cust ID in 101, 102, 103. So it will check if the cust ID for every row, it will check if it is 101, then only we can see. If 102, then 103. That means we are restricting the columns and at the same time we are restricting the rows. That means I am creating a view with three rows, that means 101, 102, 103, and with three columns, custody, account number, account type. These are the three rows and three columns. I am giving permission to the user to access that particular view. Okay, so like that we can create the view by using this vertical view and also the horizontal view. Both also we can create a view. By using this both also we can create a view. So next we are having another view known as grouped view. Grouped views. So this grouped views contains a group of clause. If the query contains a group by clause, group by clause. Okay. So what is a group by clause? That means it will group up the particular column that we have specified. For example, group by department. That means it will bring all the employees who are working in one department. That is, suppose we are having one sales department. It will display all the employees. It will store all the employees. We can see all the employees which satisfies the condition department is equal to sales. Purchases, and next it will display some sales, purchases and manufacturing department, like that. So it will group up the rows according to the condition that we have given. So create view, view group by department, number of employees as select department count, employee ID from employee manager group by department. We are creating a view from employee manager and grouping by the department, grouping up by the department. That is about this grouped views. Next is the joined views. So these joined views are created by specifying a two table or three table query in a view creation command. So here in a view, we will join the two or more tables here by using this joined views. So if you want to join a two tables, in the previous session we have discussed about the join condition. So in views also we can create a join here. So create view, my view name is view cust join, as select a cust ID, cust first name and cust last name, amount in dollars, from customer loan A, customer details B, where A dot cust ID is equal to B dot cust ID. That means I am having two tables, customer loan and customer details. For this customer loan, I am giving alias name as A, and customer details I am giving alias name as B. Okay, so if you want to combine two tables, I told you the one column should be the same. That means cust ID is the same column in both customer loan and customer details. By using this condition, A dot cust ID is equal to B dot cust ID, I am combining the two tables A and B and creating a view here. Okay, so from A, here I am select A dot cust ID. So in A table, I am taking cust ID, one column. In B table, I am taking cust first name. In B table, I am taking cust last name. Okay. And amount in dollars. And amount in A dot amount in dollars, I am taking. So, by using, I am selecting some columns in A and I am selecting some columns in B. And I am combining those two and creating, and I have created a view. That view is nothing but joined view. That view is nothing but join view. So next we will see about this SQL subqueries. SQL subqueries. So what is a subquery? A subquery is a SQL query nested inside a larger query. That means nested queries are nothing but subqueries. So what is the use when the subquery occurs? A subquery may occur in a select clause, or it may occur in a where clause. The subquery can be nested inside a select, insert, update or delete statement, or inside another subquery. A subquery is usually added within the where clause of another select statement. We can also use the comparison operators like greater than, less than or equal to. The comparison operator can be a multiple row operator such as in, any, or all. So these are all the places where the subquery can occur. These are all the places where the subquery can occur. The syntax of this subquery. So here, select a select list from table where expression operator. That means select select list from table. That means, so here we are having the this red mark is the having, this is the subquery. In one select we are having the, I mean, this select statement, this subquery exists in the where clause. This subquery exists in the where clause. So if it is a subquery, we will enclose it with the braces. So the subquery, which is nothing but inner query, we can also call it in a inner query. The subquery executes before the main query. Okay, so main query and subquery. First of all, the subquery exists, and next, based on the particular subquery, so this subquery is in the where clause. So based on the where clause, it will execute the main query. First of all, it will execute the subquery, that is inner query. The result of the subquery is used by the main query. That particular result will be used by the main query. Next, types of subqueries. So we are having different types of subqueries. Single row subquery returns 0 or 1 row. Multiple row subquery returns 1 or more rows. And multiple column subqueries, that means returns 1 or more columns. It returns 1 or more columns. These are the three types of subqueries we are having. So we will see about this single row subqueries. A single row subquery returns only one row. That is, the single row query uses any operator in the query. That is, less than, greater than, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to. So we are having the two tables. We are having employee table and department table. Employee table and the department table. So by using these tables, we can create a single row subqueries. Suppose we want to find out the e-name, job, sal of the employees whose salary are less than that of the employees whose employee number is equal to 7876 from the emp table. That means you want to find out the name, job, salary of the employees whose salary is less than the employee whose ID is 7876. So here we will write, here we will find out the salary of the employees whose employee number is equal to 7876. Okay, so for that query we will write select sal from emp where employee number is equal to 7876. Okay, so first of all we will find out the salary of a particular employee whose employee number is equal to 7876. That's why we are writing here select sal from emp where employee number is equal to 7876. Then we will write the subquery here. So select ename, job, sal from emp where sal less than 1100. So first of all we have find the minimum salary, that is 1100. So now we want to find the employees whose salary is less than 1100. So we are having two employees, Smith and the James. So here instead of writing those two queries individually, so those two queries can be combined into one subquery. Those two queries can be combined into one subquery. So the above two queries can be used as a single query by using the concept of subquery. So here we can write those two queries can be combined into one query, that is select ename, job, sal from emp where sal less than select sal from emp where employee number is equal to 7876. Okay, so first of all, the inner query, that is select sal from emp where employee number is equal to 7876. It executes this inner query will execute. So first of all, it will find what is the salary of this particular employee number 7876. We have seen previously that is 1100. Okay, so that sub query returns 1100. So then the main query will be executed. What? Select ename job sal from emp where sal less than 1100. So this query, inner query, returns the value 1100 to the main query. Then it will be executed according to that where clause, according to the condition. So that is how to combine the two subqueries. And next is the multiple row subquery. We are having multiple row subquery. So this multiple row subquery returns a set of rows. This query uses the set of comparison operators like in, all, any. If we use a multiple row subquery with all the equal comparison operators, the database will return an error if more than one row is returned. It returns an error if more than one row is returned. So in, we are having the symbol in. In means equal to any member in the list. Any returns rows that match any value on a list. All, it returns all the rows that match all the values in a list. These are the three symbols we are having. These are the three operators we are having. Comparison operators. In, any, all. So here we will see a small example for in operator. The in operator returns true if the comparison value is contained in the list. The following statement finds the employees whose salary is the same as the minimum salary of the employees in the department. So the in operator means it returns true. It returns the true if the comparison value contained in the list. Okay, it will check, it will return the true. So here we will see the example. Select ename comma sal from emp where sal in, select min sal from emp group by department number. That means, so first of all, the inner query is select min sal. It will select the min sal from the employee group by department number. So first of all, it will group up the department numbers. In emp table, we are having the three departments, 10 department, 20 and 30. So it will take the minimum salary from 10, 20, it will group up the 10, 20, 30 employees, and it will take the minimum salary, whether it is in 10th department number, 20 department number and 30 department number. It will take the minimum salary from both, from the department numbers, and it will give the ename, sal and emp. Select ename, sal from emp, where sal in. It will check the salary, whether what is the minimum salary in these three departments. So that means it will give the minimum salary. It will give the minimum salary in the departments. And next is the any operator. The any operator returns true if the comparison value matches any of the values in the list. It returns true if the comparison value matches any of the values in the list. So display the employees whose salary is more than the minimum salary of the employees. So minimum salary of the employees in any department. It will display the, we want to display the employees whose salary is more than the minimum salary of the employees. So for that we will write select ename sal from emp where, we are using the where class, where sal greater than any select max sal from emp group by department number. Here we are giving the, we are grouping up the department number and from we are selecting the max sal. Previously we have selected the minimum salary. Okay, max sal greater than, so where sal greater than the max sal in all the departments. So that is about this any operator. And next we are having another operator known as all operator. It returns true only if the comparison value matches all the values in the list. So comparison value will match all the values in the list, then only it will return the true value. So display the employee details with salary less than those whose job is manager. So here we are having select employee number, ename, job, sal from emp, where sal less than all. Here we are using the all operator. That means select sal from emp where job is equal to manager and job not equal to manager. So we are selecting the, we are selecting, here we are selecting the, first of all, the inner query will be executed, select sal from emp where job is equal to manager. So it will select the salary of the job is equal to manager. It will select the salary of the manager, and here we are displaying the salary less than those whose job is now is manager. Okay, so first of all it will select the employee salary and it will compare with the manager. Okay, so if compare with the manager, if it is less than only, it will display the records. That is about this all operator. So that means it returns true only if the comparison value matches all the values in the list. The comparison value matches all the values in the list. That is about this all operator. So we are having three operators here: any, all, and any, all, and in operator we are having. And next is the multiple column subquery. Multiple column subquery, a subquery that compares more than one column between the parent query and subquery is called the multiple column subquery. So here list the employees that makes the same salary as other employee with employee number is equal to 7521 with the same job also. Okay, so the salary should be the same and also the job should also be the same. Okay, so select ename, job, sal from M, where we want the two columns should be the same. Okay, job and sal, that is job and the sal, where job comma sal, in, we are using the in operator. Select job, sal from emp, where employee number is equal to 7521. The employee number 7521, that particular job and salary it will take, and it will compare the other rows and it will display the employees who are having the same job and the same salary. Okay, so that is about this multiple column subqueries. So these are the different types of subqueries we are having. So deleting the tables, how to delete the tables? So one can delete from a table by using the delete from statement. The rows can be deleted from the state particular table. The delete statement removes rows from the table, but it does not release the storage space. The rows will be deleted, but the structure will be remaining. So how to delete the rows? Delete from table name. Delete from table name. Suppose I want to delete all the records from the student table, then I will give delete from student. So the total rows that we are having in the student are 4. So query okay, 4 records will be deleted, effective. That means it will be deleting all the records, but the structure will be the same. So if you want to release the memory also, if you want to release the occupied space also, then we will give the drop command. Then we will give the drop command. That is the difference between the delete and the drop. So these are the different queries and subqueries in this session. Thank you. Thank you one and all.
I never said it.